Right, there we go. We now should have audio. Thank you very much to everybody for watching live. I have just seen the chat and I have just seen all the messages saying that there was no audio. Apologies for that. I had exactly the same problems last time. So we'll start again. Hello, everybody. Thank you very much for joining in and for bearing with us through the sound problems. Today, going to be doing a two-player playthrough against Tyler, who is over there. Tyler is going to be the green player today. Say hello, Tyler.
Hey.
They probably heard you saying hello earlier on. It was just me that they couldn't hear. So yeah, this is the second video in a series of videos that I'm doing to help people learn how to play Through the Ages. We're going to be using the digital adaptation of the game today. The first video I did was last week, where I did a solo playthrough, where I played against two AI players. Today, playing a two-player game against another real person, so no AIs today. And this video, we're not going to be playing a full game today. The plan is that we're going to be streaming for about an hour and a half. I'm hoping to get through halfway through Age 2. That's the plan for today. But yeah, going to be doing an hour and a half today, and then we'll finish next week. The other thing, for those of you that watched the last week's video, you'll know that the digital version actually comes with options where you can play with digital rules or with the original board game rules. And today we're going to be using the original board game rules. That affects the way that events are resolved and the way that territories are bid for. So yeah, we've switched on the toggle to say that we're playing this with original board game rules. Normally when you would play digitally, you generally speaking, you would play the digital rules because it does speed up the game. But we're going to be doing that today, which is perfectly suited for live. Right. Okay. So what else did I say earlier on that I've forgotten to say now? Contest. That was it. So CGE are giving away two keys to the game. You can see a link at the bottom. There you go. cge.as/grcontest. If you go to that website now, there'll be a Google form. You do not have the answers yet to be able to fill in the form, but those answers are coming. So if you're watching this live, open that form in another window and go over to it and answer the questions as you get them. If you're not watching this live, that's absolutely fine because this video is going to be on YouTube forever. Forever sounds weird. Anyway, it's going to be on YouTube. The contest closes on Monday. So Monday, the 1st of June. If you're watching this after the 1st of June, that Google form will have disappeared. It won't accept responses anymore. And on Monday, I'll be picking two winners. And if you already own the game, please enter the contest anyway, because if you win, you can gift the code to a friend. Right, that's everything. So yeah, we've got comments in the chat saying that they've upped the quality of the leaders with animated images of people sat at home. So yes, there you go. Right, we are going to make a start. The other thing is I'm not going to be doing a full tutorial today. We are just going to be mainly playing and talking about our decisions. So if you are completely new to the game, I would recommend checking out my other video first, where I actually go into a lot more detail about how the game plays. Other than that, let's crack on. Let's get rid of the giveaway thing for now, which is that one. And I'm not going to be able to see the chat messages constantly. I will try and keep an eye on it, but I'll be concentrating mainly on the game. So, fate has decided that Tyler is going first. So, off you go with your first card. And talk us through the decision you're making.
Yeah, so I think taking either a leader or a wonder as a first action is pretty important. Mm-hmm. And both of these leaders I like, but I'm going to go ahead and take Kamurabi.
Okay.
Because I think being able to have that versatility early on using your military actions as civil actions is helpful.
Yep.
My favorite leader is Caesar to take in AJ, but he is
not out
right now.
Yeah.
No.
See, I think the same thing as you. I think I generally always take a wonder or a leader at the start. But in a two-player game, we know that Caesar's going to come out at some point. So if you really wanted Caesar, you just wait for him to come out. Well, he might come out.
Yeah.
He should come out. There's one or two cards from AJ that don't come out. But yeah, I'm not sure. I mean, obviously the yellow cards I don't think are as powerful to take at the start, but yeah
we'll see. I only had the choice between the yellow cards or a leader, so I think taking a leader was probably the better move then.
So, yeah, if you take that...
I should end my turn.
Yep, there you go. And then do your end turn.
Yep.
Right, so my go. Oh, that was a bit loud. That was the indication telling me that it was my turn. Even though I have my headphones plugged in, For some reason, that sound is coming out of my monitor. I don't know why. so I'm just going to turn that sound down on my monitor. It shouldn't be doing that. And it was quite a loud bing. Right. I'll tell you what. I'm going to go against what you said. And I'm going to take Engineering Genius. Two reasons. The first reason is I think Engineering Genius is an absolutely fantastic AJ card. Because it effectively saves you two resources and allows you to build an early wonder easy. The other thing is Aristotle is my favorite AJ leader. So that allows me to take Aristotle as well. My other option would be to not take either of those and instead take Pyramids or Colossus. I would only do that if I really wanted that card and I was thinking you might take it instead. But as it is, I'm going to take Engineering Genius and Aristotle, and that is my turn done. Okay, nice, easy first round. Yeah. Now we go into Age 1 proper.
Oh, and there's Caesar.
There he is. So Caesar has come out, Moses has come out, but you can only ever have one leader from each age. Yeah. So Tyler has already chosen that Hammurabi is going to be his leader. Even though he's not in play yet, he's taken the card, which means he can't take any AJ leaders. So all of these other green cards here, they are now not going to do anything at all.
Yep.
Right.
I am, however, going to take Colossus.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting.
I like the colonization boost it gives you.
Yeah. So when the app first came out, Colossus had been changed. When they released the expansion, they also released a few card tweaks. So this is the better version of Colossus that was originally printed, that originally came with the game. And yes, it is nice now. I'm still stuck in thinking I'd take Pyramids over Colossus, but you're right. Colossus, that strength boost and the colonization boost in a two-player game. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
It's going to be one of those games, then, is it?
Go ahead and put Hammurabi in play.
So this is interesting because I've never streamed a game played like this. I can't see what you're doing.
Oh, okay.
Until you press end turn. And then when you press end turn, then it will show me your moves. Okay? So we can't actually see what Tyler's doing at the moment.
Mm-hmm. And then I'm just trying to kind of debate between the yellow cards I have available. I think I am going to go ahead and take Urban Growth and Stockpile over Patriotism. And that'll be it. I don't think I'm going to use my extra military action that I can use as a civil action this turn.
So you're going to draw... you're just going to draw two military cards.
Yeah.
Okay. There we go. And now we can see what's happening. So Tyler has started to build the Colossus. It isn't finished yet, but he started to build it. But the fact that he's taken that means that as soon as that gets completed, he's going to gain... That's still really loud. Right. As soon as he's finished building the Colossus, that's going to give him two military strength. And military strength, as you'll know, if you know the game, is important. If you don't know the game, military strength's really important. And that's going to get him a good boost on military strength early on, which is worrying. So, turn two, and I'm already worried. So what am I going to do? Let's switch to me. So we've got Aristotle, who's probably my favorite leader. Now, Hanging Gardens is my favorite wonder from AJ. I think I'm probably going to take it, just because it is my favorite one. But Library of Alexandria is my second favorite one. And I don't know whether I should switch and stick with the library. No, I think we're going to go Hanging Gardens. So I'm going to take Hanging Gardens. I'm going to start building that. I'm going to increase my population and build a mine because they're two of the standard opening moves, which you didn't do, Tyler.
No. Nope.
You didn't, did you? You took two yellow cards. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Was there a reason for that?
Just trying something new.
Okay. Because I think I said last time, 99% of the time, you want to increase your population and build a mine. So Tyler's playing that 1% of the time. Some off-the-wall strategy that might work. So we've got one action left. I've done everything I need to do. Do I want to play one of these? No, I think I'm going to put Aristotle into play. It's not going to help me right now, but it means I don't have to waste an action next turn doing it. Right, that is me done. Right, now at this point, because the civil cards are a public knowledge, so we can both see what civil cards we've both got in hand. The military cards are kept secret, so you know exactly how many cards the other player has in hand. So I know Tyler has two military cards here, but we don't know what they are, okay? And obviously we're not going to be revealing that to each other during the game. But, oh, right, you've played one as an event. Right.
Seed the deck here.
So development of markets. So if we were playing with the digital rules, what would happen now is that the game would basically plant a little pointer into my system that the next time it is my turn, I get a choice of two food or two rocks. Because we're playing with the original board game rules, we make that decision right now. So you can see if you were playing this asynchronously using the app, it would slow things down because Tyler's now got to wait for me to make a decision. Whereas playing it live is fine. I'm going to gain two rocks because that's going to allow me to finish the Hanging Gardens on my next turn. What about you?
I did the same thing, so I can just go ahead and right now finish Colossus.
So Colossus is going to cost you six resources to build, which is what you've got. Yeah. I mean, early on in the game, you almost always take resources rather than food, I think.
Yeah. Went ahead and increased my population. I'm going to do it twice, actually.
Okay. You've got enough food to do that. Yep.
Discontent worker.
It'll be fine.
Yeah. I still don't think it's worth using my... I'd rather have those two military cards than take an extra action as of right now. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to go ahead and end my turn.
Okay. Right, so the Colossus has been built. You can see Tyler's strength has gone up to 3. Now that's fine for now because we're still in the Age A military cards. So these aren't going to hurt me. But I don't know what cards he's been putting into the event deck here. Presumably he knew he was going to be ahead on military strength. So he's been putting possibly territories in there because he's got one boat. Or he might have been putting some of the cards which hurt the weakest player. So I need to have a look at my military cards and decide if I want to play these or not. So I'm going to play this one for reasons that will hopefully be obvious to people watching the stream. It's a special card that's only in this version of the game, Tyler. It's called Paul Wins the Game.
Ah.
So, yeah, I got Vlodger to create it for me.
So, it's a powerful card.
It is a powerful card. Development of civil life. Right, so each civilization can either increase its population, build a farm, urban building, or develop a technology, and it basically costs one less. Oh, now... what do I want to do? bearing in mind I'm about to finish the Hanging Gardens, I probably don't want a temple. I think I'm just going to increase my population, actually. Yeah. What are you going to do with that?
I think I'm going to build a mine.
Okay. Right, Tyler's built a mine. Okay, so back to me. Four actions. Is masonry out? Oh, look at that. Now, sometimes the game works absolutely beautifully and exactly what you want. And that's happened now. So I take masonry, and because I've taken a technology card, I gain one science because of Aristotle, which means I now have enough to play masonry, which means I can then play engineering genius and then use the masonry to complete the other two stages of the Hanging Gardens. Yeah, that's almost a perfect turn with use of the actions. So that is me done. Hanging Gardens has been built. So rather than having a big metal man, I've got some nice gardens. Right. Over to you, sir.
Yep, I'm waiting for it to show me what you did.
Tony's in the chat saying he used to play a card game with his brother called I Win. He could never get the rules. Excellent.
All right, seeding another card.
Okay.
The deck here.
We'll get two rocks. Excellent.
I'm going to take knights, and I'm going to take knights. Iron.
Interesting. So you've taken two cards that both cost 5 science to play.
Yes.
But you're not going to be able to play either of those anytime soon.
I am going to play Urban Growth to build a new lab.
Right.
There. hoping that that last AJ card is the one that will get me a free temple.
Gotcha. Right. Okay. That'll sort out your happiness problem.
Yeah. Taking a little bit of a chance here.
It is a low chance in a two-player game.
Yep.
So, no, it's interesting because so you've taken knight to nine, which both cost five to play. You're going to have five next turn, but then it's going to be a while before you get the other one. So you don't have to answer this, but I'm curious which one of them you're going to put into play first. And I think I know. I think you're going to put iron into play because you're ahead on military strength. And you've taken the knight planning for the future rather than the immediate, is what I'm thinking.
Then, no arenas are typically looked on as not too powerful, but
I like him.
I do too.
Because I don't like building temples.
Yeah. I'm considering taking Breaded Circuses, but the problem is I already have two technology cards in my hand.
Yeah.
So,
well, you can put back
makes it a little less appealing.
Yeah. If you were taking the knights just so I didn't get them, obviously it's a two-player game, so those first three cards are going to disappear. Cards go quick. Scott is in the chat saying that the interface is very slick, but he's never played it, so he's no idea what's going on. Yes, watch the previous video where I go into a lot more detail and talk through how it plays. But yeah, so the interface is very slick.
Yeah. Written head and took frugality, ending the turn.
So you took knights, you took iron. You then played urban growth to build a lab. You then took frugality. And then you ended your turn. And you drew a card. There you go. Right.
Not realizing that, foolishly not looking and seeing that there was a frugality for one civil action cheaper that I could have taken.
Oops. Right. Okay. So number of play mistakes to Tyler 1, Paul 0. Okay, so am I going to play a card into the event deck? So bearing in mind, again, if you're not used to the game, playing cards into the event deck when you're behind on strength can be dangerous because a lot of the events actually trigger and give a bonus to the player who is ahead on military strength. At the moment it's safe because there's one AJ card left, but as soon as that's gone, all of these age one cards are going to come in play and I don't know what they are. Let's have a look at these. Okay, right. Need to just check the current situation. I don't know whether I want to play any of these based on what's happening right now. If I don't play any of these, because of course you can undo a lot of things in this game, which is great. You can play your entire turn and then undo it. But at any point new information is revealed, you can't undo beyond that point. So if I play a card now, this is going to get revealed, which means I then can't undo it because that would be cheating. So I need to make this decision now about which one I'm going to play, if I'm going to play one. And you know what? I don't think I'm going to play one. No, I'm not going to play an event. Because I might be bluffing. I might not have an event in hand, at which point I've spent a long time bluffing. Right, so my four actions. What are we going to do? We had a great turn last turn, but this turn we need to do stuff because we've got six resources, burning a hole in my pocket, and I'm going to suffer 2 points of corruption if I don't do something. I've only got one science. Now, Aristotle is still good for me for now. See, now I've got two happy faces from the Hanging Gardens. I don't know whether I need the Bread and Circuses. Because two happy faces at this point in the game is fine. But sooner or later, we're going to need more than two. And that Bread and Circuses will actually help me try and recover some of the strength deficit. The other option as well is that I could just build more warriors. Because I do have... Oh yeah, I actually have lots of resources that I need to spend. So... Let's have a think. I am tempted by swordsmen. The sooner you get away from warriors, the better. But swordsmen are going to cost me four science, and I don't have the science. So I tell you what, let's build one warrior to start with, and let's look at the situation now. So that's got me two military strength. still behind. I could increase my population again. Right, so that's the corruption problem sorted. What do I do now? Do I build another lab? I think I do. I think I'll build another lab. It's a real shame that alchemy went, because alchemy is such a brilliant card early on. That's going to mean that I'm generating two signs. I'm going to take the swordsman. Yeah. Since you built the Colossus, I'm going to take the swordsman. And then I'm also going to take... I've got one action left. What am I going to do with that one action? I think... I'm going to generate one food. I won't have enough. Do I take reserves? Oh. Yeah, I think I'll take reserves. It's not amazing, but there we go. That is my turn done. I have to discard a card, and I'm going to discard... I'm wishing I played that now. Yeah. Yeah, I should have played that. Anyway, I'm going to get rid of that one. No, that one. Okay, right, over to you, sir.
All right. Skipping to your turn, here we go. So, I'm going to skip my politics phase for now.
You're not going to do a political action?
Nope.
But this is the thing, you know what I was saying earlier on about you undoing? You could now play your entire turn, then undo it, and then choose to play a political action.
I could.
Yeah. Again, no new information is revealed, so you can undo all the way back to the point where some new information was revealed. Matt Prowse is in the chat saying that there are few games where he completely prefers the digital version, but this is one of them. And I have to agree, whilst I really like the physical version and I like the table presence and moving the bits about, the digital adaptation of this is just fantastic.
Yeah, I hear that from a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to play... See, Frugality I don't really want to play right now because I kind of want to spend food if I get it. Although, actually, that will let me not...
Play it and see what happens.
I'm going to go with Iron.
Right. Yeah, I thought you would.
Yep. You were correct. I'm going to go ahead and build or an upgrade one of my mines here.
Mm-hmm.
Now I have a tough choice because I want Monarchy and I want Joan of Arc.
Right, okay.
However, I'm only going to get a chance at one of those cards.
Because you've only got one civil action left?
I've got three cards in my hand.
Oh, right, yes. You're at your hand limit, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Although I could play, if I play one of my yellow cards, I still won't have enough actions left to take those. So, do I want Joan of Arc? I don't have any temples yet.
Right.
So she won't give me that strength bonus, but that extra military action and that culture production is nice.
Yeah.
Monarchy, though, also nice. If I go to Monarchy, I'd probably do a revolution to get to it. So is it worth that at this point? I'm going to take Joan of Arc.
Yeah, you would lose your entire next turn.
Yeah.
But sometimes that's worth it. I know one of the things that I'm not good at in this game is switching my government early. Because I always think, oh no, I don't want to miss a turn. I don't want to miss a turn. And I end up, you know, three quarters of the way through the game and I'm still despotism. And everybody else has got like a gazillion actions and I'm still on four. So, yeah.
And then, not quite enough. I'm going to just play Stockpile to get it out of my hand. It won't make me corrupt, get me a little bit of resources. Still don't have quite enough to build a temple, but now I can play Frugality, and that would make me corrupt if I did, because I would spend three but gain two. Put me right at the corruption mark.
Yeah.
So I am not going to do that at this point. So I'm just going to end my turn.
Okay.
And
we will now get, it will now play back what's happening. And this is the other great thing with this app, is that if you're playing a four-player game of this, when you get a notification that it's your turn, it will basically replay all of the other players' turns so you can see exactly what they've done. So here you go. Tyler developed iron, upgrades bronze to iron, takes Joan of Arc, play stockpile. And there we go. Right. So, 'tis my go. I am in the situation again where I may play an event and I may not play an event. And I think at this point, based on that, 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 and that, let's just have a look at how much we are generating each. Yeah, okay, I'm going to put this card into the event pile. So this has revealed the last Age A event. So there are four Age A cards in a two-player game, and that's those gone. Four of them are taken at random out of a pack of 10. So we all get some stuff. One science, one food, and one rock. But now the Age 1 events have been shuffled in. And if I click on that, you can see they are the two that I put in, because it's got my player colour, and I can actually see what they are. So it shows you what cards you've put in. And the other two are the ones that Tyler put in. We don't know what they are. Now, although that image there looks like my cards are coming out next, it's not. These are all shuffled. We don't know the order in which they're coming out. Right, okay, so what am I going to do? Well,
didn't get to build my free temple.
Nope. Now, I am going to develop Swordsman as a technology. Now, I'm still behind on strength. If I... Oh, maybe I won't. Hang on. There's Breakthrough. I really like Breakthrough because science is so important early on.
Yeah, oh, Breakthrough is great.
Alchemy's there as well. Oh. Breakthrough, Irrigation, and Alchemy are probably my three favourite Age 1 cards. Not counting, obviously, leaders. Oh, and Cartography and Masonry is good. In fact, they're all good. apart from Columbus. I don't like Columbus because every time I take him, I never draw any territories. And then in the game that I draw territory, I don't get Columbus. It's just... So I was thinking of playing Swordsman to try and catch up a little bit on the military because I'm a little worried about these events that have been put in. But if I don't do that, we could start improving this instead. I mean, that's going to be really good. Right, let's just work through this. If I take Alchemy and then play Alchemy and then upgrade one of those and then build another warrior, that's the corruption sorted. Is that good? Do I like that? Am I happy with that? I don't think I am. No, I'm not happy with that. So I'm going to undo that. That was one of the things that I was thinking of doing, but I'm not going to. So instead, how about I take that and that, so I've taken Breakthrough, taken that, I could do that. Yeah, I'm not really building very much this turn, and I can't take any other cards in hand. I could develop this. And then that would give me, how much science would I then have next turn? I'd have 5, which is enough for the swordsman. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I mean, that's not as good a turn as I was going to take if I'd have built the alchemy. I say not as good a turn, but I'm planning for next turn. So I think that is quite good. I've got rid of the corruption. Yeah, we're going to do that. There you go. You can see what I've done. Mm-hmm. Matty's saying, how long are we going to be playing for? So the plan is today to play for 1.5 hours. That should get us through Age 1, easily. In fact, we're going to be out of Age 1 in probably about 15, 20 minutes. The plan was to play until we're about halfway through Age 2. So yeah, either 1.5 hours or to halfway through Age 2, whichever comes first. Right, we have a territory that's come out. So this is a card that you put in. I know that because I didn't put it in.
Yep.
And this is where we're using tabletop rules. So instead of the digital rules where we each make a secret bid and then the app decides who won, were basically each taking it in turns. So Tyler bid two. Now I know, because he's got one ship, that that's actually a, he's bidding one and he's getting a bonus of one. But if I want to beat that, I'm going to have to bid three. And he doesn't know what cards I've got in my hand, because there are some cards that you can play that boost it. So I need to decide. And the problem is, if I do win it, then I'm going to be losing these soldiers, and I actually have plans for them. So nope, I'm going to pass. That is your territory for a bit of two, which is actually just one.
Yep.
So one warrior goes off and colonizes the new land.
This one was good for me, because now I can...
Yeah.
First, I'm going to replace...
That was really good for you.
Yeah. I'm going to replace Hammurabi with Joan. I'm going to go ahead and use my military action from Hammurabi.
Nice.
Place.
Get the use out of him before he disappears. Mm. Yeah.
Going to then put knights into play, because I can do that now.
Yeah, that science boost was really useful for you.
Yeah. Going to build one unit of knights.
Okay, so... And that's sometimes the good thing. If you win that territory and you have to sacrifice that unit, sometimes you actually wanted to, because then you get the yellow disc back, you have to buy it again with food, but then, you know, if you were going to reassign it elsewhere, it's pretty good.
Yeah. And then I increased my population twice, and I built a temple, since I didn't get the free temple I was hoping for.
Yeah, because your happy faces is a problem at the moment, isn't it?
Yep, but not anymore.
So you don't have any, but because you got the... how did you get these extra yellow workers?
From the territory.
Right. Oh, yes, it was one extra.
One extra, and then the guy who I set off to colonize it. Yep.
Yeah. Let's just have a look at Tyler's, what he's done here. Yeah, so he got an extra yellow blob from here. So there we go. So... His military strength is now 5 because he's got a knight here. So the knight is giving 2, Joan of Arc is giving 1, and the Colossus is getting 2. So yeah, Tyler's got a military strength of 5. And in this game, obviously, if the events trigger and they give a bonus to the player who has the highest strength, that's just straight up as it is. Otherwise, you do get these aggressions in the game. And in order to be safe from an aggression, you need to be within a few points of them. And at the moment, there's a 3-point difference in strength. And because I can only play 2 cards in defense, because I've got 2 military actions, that means if I have a defense card, which is worth 2, and any other card which is worth 1, we're fine. But basically, yeah, the closer you are in military strength, the safer you are. And at the moment, a difference of 3 is a little bit nervous about that. But remember, I am about to play Swordsman. So, do I want to play one of these cards? Yes, I'm going to play this card, and I'm hoping one of my events comes out. No, it's one of your events. Okay, so that's good for me, in that I know what the 2 events left in the deck are. Because, yeah, I didn't play that one. A good harvest, we both gained 2 food. Okay, so I'm playing Breakthrough in order to develop Swordsman. Then I am going to... look at all these resources. I could just build a new Swordsman straight up. Yeah, there you go. So I built a new Swordsman. I want to build another one. Oh, look at Alchemy. Oh, he's still there. How didn't it go? look at these leaders. Oh, they're all so good. Yeah, spoil for choice here. I'm so tempted to take Alchemy, but... We've only got 11 cards left of Age 1, and there's going to be some better cards coming out later. In fact, has the library come out yet? No. The 2 libraries haven't come out yet.
Nope.
Wow.
You do still have your Age A leader, and it's getting close to the end of Age 1.
It is. I'm just thinking, which one of them do I want to take? Because if I'm going to go down the library or lab route, Leonardo is good. Mm. But Michelangelo is here. And you can't take Michelangelo because you've taken Joan of Arc. So right. I will be able to take Michelangelo. And that's going to help, because that combos with Hanging Gardens really well.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So, difference in strength of 5-4. I'm just going to check the events that I put in the deck. Okay. What would you do?
I also see, I don't know what resources you've spent, but you had a lot to spend
Yeah, I've still got five
to
left.
prevent.
I tell you what, I haven't upgraded my farms, and I probably should at some point. I mean, I don't need to right away. No, I think I'm going to take alchemy. So I'm taking alchemy. I can play alchemy, and then I can upgrade. So that's all of my civil actions gone. Except I am going to be corrupted, but I can avoid the corruption by building another. Right, you're not going to like this when I click end turn, because I've now got 6 military strength. I'm going to get rid of that card. I just spent all of my resources, built an upgraded lab to keep Derek happy, and built two swordsmen as well as two warriors. So yeah, this is my army now, two warriors and two swordsmen. Unfortunately, I haven't drawn any tactics cards.
You've got me beat right now on a military strength. I'm gonna skip my political step.
I've got you worried.
I really like
Oh, but
cartography
you know
and I
what card's
like
on top of the deck,
warfare.
don't you?
I do.
Yeah. Ah, yeah, because Joan of Arc allows you to look at the card on the top of the deck. So. So you've got no cards in hand at the moment.
Yeah, thinking about what I want to take. I think patriotism is a definite for me.
Okay. Build up your military.
Yeah. I'm going to go ahead and this turn build another knight.
Right. Yeah, you're out producing me on resources at the moment. You're generating four instead of my three. It's not too bad though.
Yep. I'm going to take cartography, which
Yeah, nice.
I'll be able to play that next turn.
Yeah, cartography is one of my favorite special technologies from the start of the game. Second to
Also
masonry.
going
Masonry is
to
amazing.
start running into food stagnation soon,
Yeah.
but we're so close to age two that I really don't want to take irrigation right
Yep.
now.
I'm the same with iron. I tend to miss the iron and then hopefully get the coal as soon as H2 starts.
Yeah. I want to build another wonder at some point. So I might take engineering genius right now, or I could take warfare, which gives me that extra military boost and an extra military action. It's in between those two for me. What I'm going to do, I think, is take engineering
Yeah,
genius.
that's the one I'd have taken.
Yeah, and I'm going to increase my population again, which will keep me from corrupting. And that'll be my turn.
I mean, that's why I built that extra swordsman last turn, is to avoid the corruption. I kind of didn't really want to, but this is interesting, the arms race between us. Because it was 6-5, now it's 7-6, and you get this in some games. You can play some games where the military aspect just doesn't happen at all, and both players just focus on, on the peaceful side of it. But if one player gets ahead on military, the other player needs to go military, otherwise they'll just get crushed. That's just the way it is. So, you know what card is on top of the deck. I don't, but I know it's one of those two. You chose not to play a card last turn, but that could have mean you didn't have a card to play, although you have quite a few cards. Do I want to play one? That's the question. What's going to be happening in the next turn? You're probably going to want to do. Oh, you're going to do that. Yeah, you're going to be playing cartography probably next turn. So your strength's going to go up to 8. Really need to get some tactics in play. Okay, so I am not going to play a card. Okay, right. I'm going to take Michelangelo. Now, do I want to use Aristotle before he disappears by taking another technology card? I don't think I do. I don't think I want to take one of these. So if we put Michelangelo into play, we'll see that my culture output has now gone to 3. Because basically he gets the benefit from the happy faces on the Hanging Gardens, which is pretty awesome. And he also makes it cheaper for me to take... Oh, in fact, Taj Mahal, I forgot. If you replaced your leader this turn, taking this wonder costs you 2 civilizations less. I can actually take Taj Mahal for free if I want to. And I think I do.
Yeah, it's a pretty good one.
It's the culture output. It's fantastic.
Yeah, and that blue cube.
Blue cube's nice, but yeah, the culture output.
Yeah.
So if I increase my population and build one stage of it this turn, if I build one stage of it next turn, then I can finish it next turn. Yeah, I think that works. Still got a civil action left, still got 2 resources left. I couldn't do that. I couldn't develop my farm, upgrade it. If I do, I'll be 3 plus 2. And I'm working out if I upgrade the farm, will I still have enough resources to build the Taj Mahal next turn? And I won't. So I'm going to undo that. What am I going to do with this one last civil action? I don't want to play it to get resources now because then I will be corrupt. I don't really want to take a card. And if I was going to take a card, I would undo it. Yeah, okay, so we're going to undo. Because I'm going to get one last use out of Aristotle. And we're going to take Warfare. Right, and then I'm going to go ahead and do what I just did, which was that, and that. Yes, I think that was it. We're all good. Now, one thing I could do, because I've got 2 rocks, I'm going to generate 3 more. That's going to be 5. Then I've got reserves, which is going to be another 2. That's going to be 7. I've actually got 1 rock spare. So I could, if I wanted to, upgrade one of my warriors to a swordsman, but I'm not going to, because I want to keep the 2 military actions, because I want to draw some better military cards. So, yeah, I think I'm done. There we go. Right, production time. And it is your go. So we are now in age 2. So you draw 3 military cards, thanks to Colossus, and we both lose 2 yellow blobs from our yellow bank. So how's your yellow bank looking? You're going to need another happy face.
Going to need another happy face soon, but I'm good right now. Again, I'm going to skip my politics phase.
Interesting.
So.
Now, are you doing that because you know what card's on top?
I can't really doing tell that, me, can you? I'll just say I'm doing that because I'm having really bad luck of the draw now in terms of events.
Okay.
So I'm going to go ahead and play Cartography to get that military strength, that extra 2 colonization.
2 boats.
I'm going to play Patriotism.
Yep.
And build another unit of knights.
So that's going to give you 3 knights.
And that will also let me play. Yep. Right there. So, and see, this turn I'm going to have an explosion of.
Oh dear.
Yeah.
I was trying hard to keep up, but yeah. Yeah, people who are watching this live, you will see in a minute Tyler's strength jump up to
I'm
something like.
I'm going to take Theocracy.
11? 12? 14.
14?
Oh,
yeah.
No.
I'm going to take Theocracy because I think that works with Joan of Arc really well. And I might be running with her for a lot of age 2 as well. Because she's working well for me right now. And then I'm going to upgrade, I think, another mine just to avoid the corruption here. And that'll be my turn.
Okay.
Gotta discard some military cards.
Yeah, because you've got a handful of military cards.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll definitely talk at the end of the game and let me know what you know, what military cards you had in hand at this point. Because
I'll just say right now it was a lot of tactics.
Right.
And then one event that would have helped you.
Right. So at least I know where all the tactics have gone. Yeah. I'm not drawing it. Right, so let's just have a quick look at Tyler's civilization here. And the reason he's on 14 military strength now is that, he drew the tactics cards of heavy cavalry that needs three cavalry units. He's got three knights, so they're two each, which is six. An extra four for that is 10. I forgot the Colossus. Yeah, two for the Colossus, one for cartography, and one for Joan of Arc. So, yeah, 14 military strength. Now, that puts me in a difficult situation, because if Tyler's got any aggression cards in hand on his next turn, that's an 8 points difference. I can't make up an 8 points difference. Well, I could if I had two age two defense cards, because an age two military defense card is worth four. There's only six of them in the entire deck, so the chances are I don't have them. Anyway, it's my go. Do I want to now play one of these, bearing in mind the current situation? And the answer is no. I do not want to put an event into the deck myself, so we're not going to. Right, action phase. So I was going to finish the Taj Mahal. So it was play reserves to get the two rocks. That gives me seven rocks. And then use one action with masonry to complete the Taj Mahal. So the good news is, in the terms of culture, which is the victory points, I've got 10 and I'm generating 6. And Tyler's got 9 and generating 2. And you find this a lot in the game, is one player will start generating a lot of culture, especially if they've got Michelangelo and the Hanging Gardens combo. And the other player might go down the military route. It's balancing it all together. So I'm doing all right in terms of actual victory points. I now need to somehow protect myself from this attack, which is going to be incoming at some point, and there's not much I can do about it. Now, there is St. Peter's Basilica, and there is a famous combo, which is Michelangelo, Hanging Gardens, and St. Peter's Basilica, and it is there, and I could take it. And I am sorely tempted to take it, but also the university on the left-hand side. I really like that as well. Let's have a look at St. Peter's Basilica. 161. See, the problem is my resources are quite low. But what's my other options? If I don't take it, what do we go down? We could take the Great Wall instead. That would actually help me, because that gives me an extra one strength for each of my infantry units. And I do have four infantry units. So that would give me a boost of four strength. And it also generates a happy face, which is good for Michelangelo, I believe. Yeah. Okay. So Great Wall is looking okay. I think I might take that. So that's those two actions, and that is it. That is the end of my turn. Yeah, so I didn't take the combo, but I think the Great Wall right now, because of the strength difference, was probably the right choice. So I'm going to get rid of that, and I'm definitely getting rid of that because of this. Hopefully people will understand what I mean in the chat. Paul's going to be running from her a lot of age two. Yes. So you said you were going to be running with Joan of Arc a lot. Matt is saying in the chat that I'm going to be running away from her a lot. Yeah, absolutely right.
I'm going to go ahead and play an aggression.
Right, we have our first aggression card. So it's 14 versus 6. We have an 8 point difference, and I can't make up that 8 points. So the aggression is successful. I'm going to concede, and you basically take five things from me. A combination of rocks and food.
And I'm going to take five resources, because I really want to delay you building the Great Wall.
Yeah, I thought you might. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thief Baggins.
Yep. I am going to go ahead and take St. Peter's, because the happy face is something I need. That culture is also something I need.
Yep.
Need to spend.
It will also boost another happy face from your temple, so that'll give you 3 happy faces in total.
Right. I'm trying to think how I want to do this. I need to spend a lot of resources. I do have that engineering genius, but I almost want to spend the resources.
St. Peter's Basilica is 1, 6, and 1.
Yeah.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, and even if I spend the resources the normal way, I'm still going to corrupt, I think. Mm-hmm. I don't think I can avoid corruption this turn.
Right. See, at this point in the game, corruption is, if it happens, it happens. Early on in the game, yeah, you really want to avoid it at all costs, but at this point, yeah, it might just happen. So I've just put the contest on screen again. If you are watching this live, there is a link, cge.as/gr-contest. That takes you to a Google form, which you don't have the answers to fill in yet, I don't think. No, you probably don't. But if you stay to the end of the video, then go to that form, fill it in, you might win a digital key. CGE are giving away 2 keys to the game. The contest is actually going to run until Monday. So even if you're not watching this live, if you're watching this at some point between now and the 1st of June, yeah, go onto that website, fill in the Google form, get entered into the contest. I'll do the draw on Monday. There you go. Right. Meanwhile, back to the game. What's happening? Mm-hmm. Ah, so here's the
picking
result of the aggression.
Picking what I want to discard. And, all right.
And he started building St. Peter's Basilica. Lost 2 rocks due to corruption. And then that is your go done. Right, so let's have a look at the situation. You've got a lot of rocks. You've got 11 of them, but 5 of them were mine. You've got 5 science, you've got 11 culture. Okay. And also, if you don't know the game, you might think, oh, Paul's running away with this. He's got 16 points and he's generating 6 a turn. Yeah, you're looking at a score of somewhere around, what, 150 to 250 to win the game. So these scores here are nothing compared to what's going to happen later on. Okay, do I want to play a card in the politics phase? And the answer is no. We're not having many events being played in this game.
Mm-mm.
And I can see why you didn't play an event last turn. Right. Now, thankfully, I've got lots of science. I just don't have any resources at all. So whatever I do, and there's no reserves out. Yeah, I'm having effectively a null turn where I can't build anything. So let's do something like constitutional monarchy. Because if you haven't got any resources, let's go with the government. Now, I can't play that this turn because it requires 12. But if I also take revolutionary idea, and what do we want to do? Do we want to play the warfare? No, I don't think I do, because I'm going to have 10, 3, 13. Revolutionary idea was going to be 4, that's 17. I could play the warfare. I could play the warfare this turn. But actually, see, I'm letting coal go. Oh, yeah, I'm going to be really hurting for resources. Because if I miss out on coal, and the reason why I'm thinking of missing out on it is because even if I take it, I can't actually play it next turn. I can't actually do any upgrades because an upgrade would cost 6. Yeah, we need the rich land to come out, or we need some reserves to come out. Yeah, I'm taking a big risk here, not upgrading my resources, but I think that's what we're going to do. Now then, do I take another card? I think, oh, how far do I want to get behind on military? I'm looking at cannon, and this is one of the things that I learned even in the previous version of the game, the original Through the Ages, is that taking the first cannon that comes out can be quite important. Because there are some good tactics cards that give you extra benefits for having cannons.
Yeah.
Now, how many of them are there in a 2-player game? According to this, there is... there's 2 of them in the game. Okay, one of them's on the card row, one of them's still in the deck. So there are 2 of them in there.
But that next one might not come out until the end.
Until the end.
Page 2.
That's why I'm worried about losing the coal. If I don't take it now, assuming there is another coal in the deck... No, there isn't. Ah, good job I looked at this. There's only 1 coal. So if I don't take that... then ouch. Okay. Oh, this is, yeah, this is a tricky choice. If I don't take the coal, I might be completely screwed. If I don't take the cannon, well, if I take the cannon, I might be able to boost my military strength up a bit. Okay, I'm going to take a big risk. I'm going to take the cannon.
Ooh.
Yeah. You'd have taken the coal?
I would have taken the cannon, which is why I'm...
Oh, right, okay.
You did. I was looking at that cannon for my next turn.
Right, okay. I'm definitely glad I took that one then. So that's going, and that's going. And here we go. So yeah, I'm hurting from the lack of resources at the moment. And especially if Tyler's got another aggression card in hand and does another attack on me and steals even more of my resources. Yeah, and that's why getting behind on military strength in this game is, it hurts. It's one of those things. And like I said in the last video, some of the people who don't like the game, that's one of the reasons why they don't like the game, is the military aspect of it. You can directly hurt somebody else, but you know, that is the game. Right, what are you looking at on your turn? Are you going to play an event or another aggression, or are you going to declare war? How many cards has he got in hand? He's got 5. Who knows what he's got? That would be an aggression then. Oh no, yep. You're going to try and kill Mike.
The question is, do I want to do that, or do I want to destroy the Great Wall?
Right, well, I'm afraid it's worked. So you have successfully infiltrated my empire. Make your choice. Do you want to assassinate Mike or steal all the bricks from the Great Wall?
I think I want to sabotage the Great Wall to keep the military as low as possible.
Right.
I think I'm going to be hoping for some wars at the end of the game.
Yeah. Just let me know while you're kicking me. If you want me to lie down on the ground so that it's easier to kick me, just let me know, and I'll more than happily do that.
Organized religion is looking really good.
Yeah. That's going to boost your happy face problem.
I'm going to go ahead and finish St. Peter's. I'm going to play organized religion.
Yeah, it's looking good for you now.
And I'm going to upgrade what I have. Still going to take corruption, but at this point that's fine with me.
Yeah, all you're doing is you're losing the resources that you stole from me.
So yeah.
It's fine.
And the main reason I stole those resources was to just keep you from building the Great Wall, which I ended up destroying anyway.
Destroying anyway, but it stopped me from doing anything on that turn.
Yep.
Right, so yeah, he's played organized religion, he's finished St. Peter's Basilica. Right, so your happy face problem is now well sorted.
Yeah.
You've got 17 military strength. Oh dear. Oh yeah, because Joan of Arc is giving even more strength bonuses.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no. Right. So let's look at my situation. I'm definitely not playing one of these event cards. So I'm just going to skip my politics phase. We're having a lot less events than you would normally see in a game. But I'm too scared, is the reason I'm not playing them. Right, so we are just going to have to hold on by the skin of our teeth. I mean, Transcontinental Railroad is fantastic, but it costs 12 resources to build, and I've got 3 with no way of getting any more. So we are going to go revolutionary idea, constitutional monarchy, so we're changing governments. We've changed to constitutional monarchy, which has given me lots more actions now. But yes, there's reserve, so I've got to take that. Do we want to stick with Mike, or do we want to switch to Isaac Newton? Isaac Newton is quite nice. James Cook's no good for me at all because I'm not going to be getting any territories. Uh, wave of nationalism is nice because I'm behind on military strength. That would give me an extra 6 rocks. Yeah. Oh, it's got to be that, hasn't it? But then again, am I really going to be able to build up that much? I don't know whether I am. Because even if I do build... how much does a cannon cost? 5. Yeah, I'll build a cannon. I'm still 8 behind, even with the cannon. So at that point, you've got to think... You know, why should I bother investing my resources into building up my military strength if I'm going to lose every aggression anyway? Maybe I won't. Maybe I will be able to defend myself a bit. So yeah, let's take wave of nationalism. And I've got 1 civil action left, and I think we will play, so I've got 5 science this turn, I'm gonna get another 3. I do have 3 rocks. If I don't spend it, I might lose them. Because Tyler's gonna come across and beat me up. Do we upgrade that? How's my food looking? Yeah, I've reached that point where I'm now stagnant on food. Have you reached that point as well?
Not quite.
No, you're still generating 1 because you got the extra yellow blob, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so yeah, let's upgrade that farm. There you go. So that's all my civil action spent. And I've now got 4 military actions. So I'm hoping I'm going to draw some more defense cards with those 4 military actions. Excellent. I drew 4 defense cards. Let's see if you believe me.
Of course, defense cards don't help you against this.
Oh, he's not declaring war. I can't see it on my screen yet, but I assume you've declared war on me.
I have.
Okay, right. 2 aggressions and then a war. Right. Well, we'll see that happen.
Transcontinental.
It's nice, isn't it? It's really nice wonder.
Yeah, it's tempting, but then cannons. I would not get if I took Transcontinental Railroad.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. I want the cannons.
You want the cannon, right. So yeah. What Tyler's thinking is if he takes this one, these 3 cards are going to disappear at the end of his round, at the start of my turn anyway, those 3 are going to disappear. That one will have gone, which means these 3 will slide down. And in a 2-player game, it's the 3 left positions which clear. So basically the cannon will be there and then it will disappear, which means he won't get to take it. So,
and then selective breeding.
Mm-hmm.
Since I don't have a age 1 farm upgrade, definitely want that one. And then I'm going to increase my pop with my last one. Still losing that 2 resources to corruption, but I'm fine on resources right now.
So it's the same problem. If you take selective breeding, you're going to lose cannon.
Right.
Okay.
So I think taking cannons and selective breeding was the...
Oh, you took cannon first. Right, okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So war has been declared. So wars in this game are a step up from aggressions. They're not resolved immediately. Tyler's basically declared war over technology, so he's going to be stealing science from me, which I'm relieved about, because if he was stealing resources, that's what I'd be worried about. But the war isn't resolved until the start of his next turn. So I've basically got my turn to try and build up my defences as much as I can, because if I don't build them up, I'm going to lose... How much am I going to lose? Science equal to the strength advantage, so I'm going to lose 9 science. Now, the other thing I can do to protect myself from that is just spend the science. If I spend it, you can't steal it.
But I can steal your blue cards.
Oh, you can steal blue cards, can't you? Oh, yes, I forgot about that. Yeah, mm-hmm. Special technology, so you can steal my masonry. Yeah.
And your warfare, if you...
And my warfare, if I play it, which I'm not going to. So I'm going to skip politics, I think. Oh, hang on. Maybe I won't now. Maybe I won't, because... Oh, no, maybe I will. Just looking at the cards that I've put on my deck and the situation here. Yeah, I'm not going to play a politics card. So we're going to skip politics. We are going to put cannon into play. And then I am going to use Wave of Nationalism that basically gives me 6 bonus resources that I can use this turn for building new military units or upgrading. So that's going to go to there for 5. And that's going to go to there for for one. So that puts me on 10. That's a difference of 7. It's still quite bad. It's still quite bad. We are then going to... So we've still got 4 civil actions left. Now then, where's the things going to give me more resources? There aren't any. Let's upgrade another farm. I think I've still got 3 left. Let's take frugality, because I will be able to get a new population next turn. I think I'm also going to take breakthrough, because he's probably going to be stealing my science. So yeah, we'll take breakthrough. I think that's the best one. Yeah, okay. So that's it. The problem is, because I spent 2 of my military actions, I'm only going to get to draw 2 military cards. And here we go. Right, which of these do I want to get rid of? Well, that will be that one, and that one, and that one. There we go. Done. I've discarded. Now, I did say we were going to play until we were halfway through age 2, but we've been playing a lot quicker than I thought. It's 4:10 now, so we'll probably play till the end of age 2, and then we'll come back next week with age 3, which will be a short video where we'll just play age 3, finish off, and then we'll have a bit of a chat about things.
Yes. So I'm going to take masonry and then 4 of your science.
4 of my science. Okay. So the war has been resolved, and yeah, he's taking all of my, he's taken masonry from me and 4 of my science. So that's going to hurt.
Now let's see if I can also take some yellow cubes from you.
Oh, you're doing an aggression as well?
No. Another war.
Another war. Oh, right. Oh, no, no. Sometimes you can get lucky with the cards. And you've drawn all of the war cards when you need them.
Mm-hmm.
So, right. So what's that, war over territory?
Yep.
Yep. Ouch. This is going to hurt. I'll just put details of the contest on screen while Tyler's taking his turn. So yeah, go to that website, cge.as/grcontest. Have a look at the Google form, fill it in, send it off. I will collate all of the results on Monday, and then I'll do the draw, and 2 people are going to win a digital copy of this game.
And I'm going to take... Do you already have selective breeding?
I do not, no.
I mean, sorry, selective breeding in my thing, and I'm looking at, do I want to take another technology?
Right, okay.
I take scientific method. I didn't take the age 1 lab upgrade, so... Mm-hmm. Yep. Either take scientific method or wait all the way until age 3 to upgrade my labs, which is waiting a while. I'm going to take scientific method.
Science is your weak point at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah.
Although I'm only generating 3.
Food, I'm now stagnant, but I have selective breeding in there to upgrade. So I'm not too worried about that. So that is it. Okay. So I built a cannon on my turn as well.
So this is the result of the previous war. So yeah, he stole my masonry. Basically stole all of the people in my empire who knew how to do masonry. And then he's declared war over territory. Right, and then he's developed cannon, built a cannon, increased population, took scientific method, and there you go. So your strength is now 20. So if I don't do anything, when that war gets resolved, I'm gonna lose 3 yellow tokens. So 3 yellow tokens are going to go from my bank, which is here. I'm going to lose these 3. And they're going to go to Tyler. And bearing in mind, age of 2 is imminent, at which point we're going to lose another 2 yellow tokens as well. Gosh. Right. So, first thing is, do I want to play an event card? And the answer is, I think, an astounding no. Right, so now it's my turn. What am I going to do? I don't have enough science to play anything. I guess I could build some more defences. We've also got Napoleon, who would help because he would boost my military strength. He gives you an extra 2 strength for each different type of military unit you have. And I have infantrymen and artillery, so that would be +4. I think we might have to, because otherwise you're just whacking me all the time with these aggressions and wars. Mm-hmm. So Okay, well, let's look at this. So I'll play frugality to get an extra person. Then we're going to... Oh, but the problem is I've got discontent workers now. I don't have enough happy faces. Oh, man. Right, well, let's just work out how this is going to work. If I was to put that there... Okay, I'm going to have to zoom. If this is red, then that's a civil uprising. You've lost the game, basically. If I was to take Napoleon and put Napoleon into play. Right, so my strength is 17, so that's not too bad. That means I'm losing...
One, I think.
I'm losing one yellow token with a strength of 17. So that's okay. I'm all right with that. So here's what we can do. I can increase my population again. I can play reserves to get some rocks. And I can build a temple. That sorted out the happiness problem. Well, temporarily, because we're about to end age two and then it's going to disappear. But is that... Am I happy with that? I think I am happy. Oh, you're going to steal one, aren't you? Yeah, okay. If I don't do that, my other options are keep this person as discontent. And then with two actions left, what could I do? I could take... the efficient upgrade, and I could take urban growth. Okay, and I'm going to leave this discontent worker here. Now, sometimes leaving discontent workers is dangerous because there are certain event cards that trigger off discontent workers. But I know the next two cards, so I think I'm okay with that. It's tricky. I'll watch my turn back, and then I'll ask you, what would you have done? Would you have built another temple at this point? I'm going to discard that. There you go. So you're going to see my turn play out now. And then I will see the war being resolved. And we are in age three.
Yeah, I think I'd wait till your next turn to... Oh, the war. Wow.
Yeah.
I did not think about that. Joan of Arc leaving play at the end of the...
Oh, hang on a minute. Yeah. Oh, has this backfired?
It has backfired.
Oh. Oh, now this is a nice end to the stream. Well, for me anyway.
Yeah.
In terms of the timing, the way that it works is that on your turn, the first thing you do before anything else is the card row. And what happened at the start of Tyler's turn, because there wasn't enough cards...
Exactly ended.
Yeah, age two ended. Yeah. And because age two ended... Joan of Arc died, which means the strength bonus that he was getting from all of his temples disappeared, which means the next thing he does in his turn is resolve the war. And unfortunately, that means for him that I actually won the war and I stole one of your yellow tokens. Wow. Yeah, hadn't thought of that. But
neither have I. You took exactly the right amount of cards from the card row to make that happen.
Yeah. Now, if I was a better player, I would have actually planned that and I would have known that that was going to happen. But that was purely accidental. Anyway, we're going to leave the stream for here. So just a quick shout again at the contest. And the last question on the contest is, who do you think is going to win the game? I'll give you a hint. Whichever answer you put is going to count as a correct answer. Okay, so it was just for fun. But at this point in the video, who do you think is going to win? Now, 5 minutes ago, I would have voted on Tyler. Now,
same.
Now, I'm not so sure now. I think it's quite wide open. But there we go. So yes, thank you so much, Tyler. This is really good. This is a good way of playing it. This worked really well. So. Yeah. The only downside being when you were taking your turn, we couldn't actually see what you were doing live, but we saw it afterwards. Cool. Thank you for joining me. Thank you to everybody for joining me in the live chat today. And hello to everybody who is watching this afterwards. We are going to pick this up next week. I don't know exactly when next week. It might be same time, same place, Thursday, 3 o'clock, or I might bring it forward to Tuesday. Are you free on Tuesday, Tyler?
Tuesday is normally our team call at CGE.
Okay. We'll stick with Thursday then. So same time, same place next week, 3 p.m. UK time. We'll come back and we will do age three, and then we'll have a bit of a chat afterwards about the game. So Thank you very much for joining in. Don't forget to enter the contest. Obviously, like the video, share it with your friends, and if you're not subscribed to me, click the subscribe button. Other than that, thank you very much, Tyler. That was a lot of fun. And
yeah, pleasure.
I'll say goodbye to you, and I'll say goodbye to everybody else watching on the stream, and I'll see you next time. Cheers all.
All right.
Gaming Rules is proudly sponsored by Game Toppers, upgrading your gaming experience. Visit GameToppersLLC.com.